curable ba ang cancer? Yes. I'll be talking about cancer today. So cancer, it's one of the leading cause of death right now in so many countries right now. And one of them is in the US, in Australia. And I think also in Phil, it's one of the leading cause of death right now. So what I can do about cancer is that we should change our lifestyle. We should always eat foods that are not processed. Okay, we should eat foods that are not sugary. So anything that's matatamis, we should not be eating them. Okay, so that's one of the way that we can stop cancer.
There's just so many cancer right now. And, you know, if I'm going to tell you one thing, before we part, you know, I just want you to know that 96% of cancer is environmental in origin.
Mm-hmm.
So,
which means what you eat, the habits that you have. I mean, for example, if you're smoking cigarettes, you have to understand there's a direct causal link between the smoking of cigarettes and lung cancers, throat cancers, you know, buccal cavity cancers. So,
madami.
Just don't smoke.
Yeah,
and understand, I was a smoker for years. I smoked for 16 years. That was one of the hardest things I ever quit. I quit 18 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm a smoker, Mom. Sorry.
So I've talked about cancer for like many years already. And again, when you have cancer, it's not because you are malas. It's because of different types of factors. So there's an interplay between your genes, your lifestyle, activity, your exposure to chemicals, even your work, mm-hmm. Your occupation, or even in your house. Just being basically in your house increases your risk of developing cancer, whether it's a toxic house. So again, we can discuss about the toxic house later. So when you are exposed to this, there's a normal cell, diba? Typically, it's normal cells. And then repeated exposure. So one time, if you have an exposure to this, you know, there was this rogue, it's called a rogue cancer. So this rogue cancer, you know, he didn't want to change himself, he didn't want to listen, he didn't want to die. Because some cancer, they would typically die. Our body would typically eat them. You call it apoptosis, okay? So usually, ayaw nilang mamatay, they would just continue growing. And then when they grow, they can be harmful to the body. They can do so many damage. Okay? So typically, if you have cancer, you will have non-specific signs and symptoms. So what's the non-specific signs and symptoms, Sir Jack?
You can have a fever. Mm-hmm. That can go with that.
You can have fever.
You can have general malaise. You can have flu-like symptoms.
Mm-hmm. Weight loss. Okay, so you cannot...
Swelling in a particular area of the body.
Yeah, anorexia. You may not sleep well, insomnia, or you might be sleeping as much. So these are non-specific signs and symptoms. You may also have bleeding. That's why some people, especially as Filipinos, you know, we will not seek a medical doctor unless some of us are dying. I'm so sorry, but that's like me. I would probably.
No,
I think it's part of the culture.
No, yeah. we really saw that a lot because they were afraid of what the doctor was gonna say, and so they would wait for 6 months. They would wait for a year, and it would get worse and worse and worse until finally they would come and see you.
Yes, and then it's already cancer. Now, the problem is, if it's big, you know, sometimes when they come to you, it's already too late. They would probably be stage 4. And that's the most heartbreaking news to tell that person is that you're already in stage 4. And then when they're already in stage 4, you have limited. Unlike if you're stage 1, you know, or in the precancerous stage, of course, these things, they have a higher chance of getting better. But if you are in stage 4, most probably,
But not a lot, okay? I don't want you to think that cancer is a death sentence, no? So, but if you are on those stages...
It's not a death sentence. What is it?
Yeah, it's a change your lifestyle sentence. Just change your lifestyle. Always remember we have an amazing machinery, body. We have an amazing body. Jehovah made it that way. So we can just... and if you have a perfect diet, like what I said, if you have a perfect diet... it can revert back. There are certain products or there are certain phytochemicals that have been proven to reverse cancer. Okay, so do not lose hope. Ayoko naman na nalulungkot kayo. Sometimes because they get so devastated, you know, when you get the news.
Yep.
Okay, so again, those are the non-specific. But what about the specific symptoms, diba? So with the specific symptoms, depending on the organ that is affected. For example, if you have breast cancer, usually you can feel a mass. Okay, may nakakapakang mass and then lymph nodes.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes the skin, you will feel it's like a pew de orang. Sabi nila, di ba? It's like the skin of the orange. So that's how it is. And then there would be bleeding as well. So now, if it's a colon cancer, most probably you would have symptoms of constipation or diarrhea or alternating constipation and diarrhea. Again, if it's colon cancer, you would have diarrhea or constipation or diarrhea and constipation. Then you would have bleeding. So when you poop or when you have your bowel movements, tatai ka ng dugo. So you can have anemia. Okay? Sometimes the bleeding can be frank. Frank, it means you can see them. They're very visible. Or it can be occult. Or you don't know it. Yeah. Tapos, makikita mo na lang through CT scan. If they will do a CT scan on you and then they would do a biopsy, okay, that's what's normally is gonna happen when you're in a doctor's office, you will know that you have a mass. So depending on the part of the colon which is affected, the symptoms can also vary. So if it's in the rectum, so you can feel the mass, mm-hmm. okay? And then sometimes you can have constipation. Now, if it's in the right colon area, you can have anemia. So that's the most common symptom. And then you can also have bleeding. Yan po yung mga symptoms. Now, if it's if it's in the prostate, you have prostate cancer, of course, you will have symptoms related to your urinary, okay? So you can have impotence. So, hindi tumatayo. Yung ari natin, hindi tumatayo. Second is, you can have dysuria, mahirap umihi. Yan, mahirapan ka ding tumae. Constipation, if you have prostate cancer. So, you have also hesitancy, yan, urgency, or you're gonna pee, tapos konti lang naman, basta iihi ka na naman. So, nagkakaroon ka ng UTI, okay? So, depending on the organ that is affected, your symptoms can vary as well.
Mm-hmm.
But do not be scared, okay? In literatures that I said, typically, an average person will develop cancer 6 times in their lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but every time they will fight it. They will fight it 6 times in our lifetime. We can develop cancer.
Known as a proto-cancer.
Yes, but we can fight it. So just have a perfect diet. I mean, if there's one thing that you can learn from this video, is that have a perfect diet. Because whatever you put in your mouth, you absorb. And if you absorb that, if it's toxic, you absorb it. You're gonna be just absorbing toxic substances.
Mm-hmm.
Whether you believe it or not, that's how it is. Okay? And then just make sure that you live in a house that's free of toxin. You know?
Toxic chemicals, toxic cleaning chemicals.
Either. Yes. Like in my house, I have a lot of plants. It's my pathos. Yeah, and they call it pathos. And then you have the fern. So these plants, they have the capability of absorbing toxic chemicals. The toxic chemicals that are usually found in the house are benzene, toluene, formaldehyde, okay? We get the benzene and the toluene from the paints, okay? The formaldehyde, we get it from our furnitures. So, especially when it's very, lalo na pag mainit, when it's hot, they can just evaporate. Tapos yung anak mo, naaamoy niya. they can smell it. You know, that's the most terrifying for me, our children.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can just smell. They can absorb, they can smell all these toxic chemicals. And then magugulat ka na lang, they have leukemia already. Especially toluene and benzene.
I actually remember as a kid, we used to have public service announcement commercials about changing the paint. Because back then, there were a lot of lead-based paints.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of children would eat them.
Mm. But that was how many years ago?
It was back in the 70s.
Oh. Imagine, I think... as far as I can remember, this came out only in Phil, like only in the 2000 something, right?
Yeah,
imagine in the US, they already know. They already know that the paints they have lead, it can cause certain health conditions.
Mm-hmm.
But as Filipinos, diba, kailan lang sinabi sa atin yan? Oh. Mm-hmm. So we do not know. But we know that there's a lot of toxic substances in... the toys in our house. So, nakakatakot. So,
actually,
just be careful with
that. Just answer a quick question that up top there, that is a humidifier.
That's a humidifier. Yan, okay. Kasi malamig. So, the problem is if it's too cold, it makes your nasal cavity very dry.
Mm-hmm.
So, usually in the morning, ang dami mo ng boogers. You will have tons of boogers.
Oh, yeah.
So, it's all over. Like my children, they all have boogers.
So, if daddy forgets to fill it up, there's lots of boogers.
Okay. So, again, just for you to know, cancer, it's not a death sentence. It's a change your lifestyle sentence. Now, nagkaroon ka na ng cancer. You have been diagnosed with cancer.
Mm-hmm.
What are you gonna do? Okay, sabi ng doctor, you have cancer. And then you say, doc, what stage? Okay, stage 4. They will tell you stage 4 like this. What is the next thing to do? The next thing to do is ask for a second opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Huwag kang maniniwala kagad. Okay?
Because these are opinions.
Yeah, opinions. And we are imperfect.
We're imperfect.
Humans are imperfect. Okay?
Well,
so it
so
doesn't
much.
Mean it doesn't mean if I tell you that you have stage 4, it doesn't mean that you really have stage 4, okay?
That,
or you have cancer.
That doctor may be looking at the wrong paperwork. You have to understand, there have been many situations where patients had come to my wife where they had gone through a double mastectomy, radiation, chemo. And as my wife would look at their paper, there was no evidence that they ever had cancer.
Mm-hmm.
None.
Mm-hmm.
Yet they would go through these things. So always get a second opinion because that person might just be wrong.
Mm-hmm. So you ask for a second opinion. Pag sinabihan ka kagad, huwag ka kagad maniwala. Even if they're professionals, even if they are not really, not professionals, but even if they're specialists. So
mm-hmm.
they have been seeing cancer patient for how many years. So it doesn't mean that if you have been in the condition 100, I mean if you have been in your practice for 10 years that you've seen tons of patient. No, you can be in a practice for 10 years or 20 years and see only 2, 3 or 5 patients.
Correct.
It doesn't mean that you're a specialist, yeah, because you went to training on a hospital, but on your practice itself, you don't see a lot of patient. Then you are not considered really a specialist. Okay, so it's better to find second, third, or even fourth opinion if you can afford it.
And always consider the credentials of the person as well. If they're planning to be, you know, some form of expert in the treatment of cancer or degenerative illnesses, are they a legitimate doctor, or do they just use that? They just use the term doc or doctor in front of their name.
Mm-hmm. And then you will be given, now, okay, you have established your cancer, your stage 4, colon cancer, stage 4, establish mo na yan. So, what's the next thing to do? The next thing to do is to ask yourself, okay, yes, this is cancer. What type of treatment do I want to have? Okay, now, I cannot say this for you. You have to decide it on your own. Do you want to do conventional medicine, which is chemo, radiation, or operation,
or
you want to do natural? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you want to go on the conventional, you have to prepare yourself. Because they will not only do chemotherapy once. They would usually do chemotherapy 6 times. Okay. Now, do you have the money for that? baka naman ang kaya mo lang is one chemotherapy, it will not make a difference. If you only can afford one chemotherapy, it will not make a difference.
No.
Or you're gonna do radiation. Radiation, how many days is the session for radiation? So that's around typically 31 to 45 days. So you, these are the questions you have to ask yourself. Your body, how about your body? Can your body undergo operation? So especially the extremes of ages, if you're very young and then very old. So can you handle the stress? So these are questions that you have to ask yourself.
Yeah, I understand that when it comes to the entire process, these people, these doctors, they are only people just like you. They've just gone through a particular set of training. And it doesn't mean that they're, you know, very, very good at it. It just means they were able to go through that particular training and pass the licensure for it. So always seek out additional opinions on this because this is your life. And ask questions. Ask a ton of questions. You know, when you start dating someone, you're perfectly willing to ask them hundreds, if not thousands, of questions. Yet when folks are diagnosed with an illness such as that, they're happy just to sit there quietly because they don't want to offend the doctor. You don't want to offend the
doctor. You have to ask questions.
Ask questions. Is this going to cure me? Does this have the potential to significantly you know, lengthen my life?
I think that's the biggest question. Gagaling ba ako? Dok, pag ginawa mo ba yan, gagaling ba ako 100%? And of course, the doctor will tell you there's no 100% assurance because there's really no 100% assurance. Okay. So, but what I'm trying to say is that all procedures, they're not 100%. Okay. Mm-hmm. You have to always research, think about it, pray. Kasi tayo naman, in the end, like what I said, we are imperfect. In the end, we really cannot save ourselves. In the end, we really have to die. And of course, for some people, cancer is like, again, what I said, a death sentence. So, some
because
of them...
Because they accept it as such.
Yeah, some of them, they will be sad, you know, they're gonna say goodbye. Like me, when I just have a fever, I already say goodbye.
I love you, honey. Goodbye. Honey, you have a fever. Come on. Such a fatalist.
Diba?
Take care of my children.
I don't know who's like me. I don't know. Katulad ko po ba kayo? I think I'm the only one who does that. Like when I'm sick, I'm having a fever. Lagi ko na lang sinasabi, ingatan mo yung mga anak natin na pag namatay ako. I know, right? I don't know. So anyway, if you decide to go, if you're a cancer patient and you decide to go conventional, and you have to know that this will take years. Hindi lang po one time. This will take years, and you may not be able to work, especially if you are only the working person in your family. Mm-hmm. Nag-iisa ka lang, diba? So you're the breadwinner.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, ikaw lang mag-isa. Tapos yung mga pamilya mo, they all depend on you. Tapos hindi mo pala kaya, naka-isang chemo ka lang, natanggal na lang yung hair mo. You just had your hair loss and you said, I don't want anymore. Then sayang. Sayang ang pera mo. Sayang lahat. Now, if you choose natural medicine, marami yan, okay? That's the dilemma with natural medicine because it's tons. Okay, and they're also not expensive. They are expensive, but they're also that are cheap. Okay, so you have to do your research if you wanna undergo treatment like that. But the best thing that you can do for yourself is to change your food, change your environment. Do not put makeup. Do not put makeup. Do not put lotion. Lalo na yung lotion I'm doing, we discovered something about the lotion and the shampoo really talaga. And they can cause absolutely infertility, absolutely cancer. It's just in all the research, in most of the research that we have seen right now. So, change your shampoo. Just simply changing your shampoo, changing your soap, your makeup, everything. It's just, you know, small changes. It can really help. You have to do
it. Cancer, it's curable. Okay? Do not believe them. Okay? at all stage, it's curable. Stage 1, 2, 3, and 4. The problem with stage 4 kasi, it's gonna be very difficult. Kasi that's actually, it's like equated to ano eh, death eh. Okay? Pagka stage 4 ka na, parang may death sentence ka na. But no, it's all curable. You can cure it. You can reverse the...